My name is Richard Aslin, and I'm a senior research scientist at Haskins Laboratories and Yale University. It's my pleasure to highlight two research projects that I've been privileged to be involved with as a result of the NTNU Haskins Joint Lab of Brain Development and Learning. These projects were led by Professor Xinmin Wang with guidance provided by Professor Ovid Zhang. Both projects use functional near-infrared spectroscopy to measure brain activation in human infants to assess their ability to predict upcoming sensory events.
我们邀请家长带着家中六个月大或十二个月大的宝贝到台师大的实验室，让家长抱着婴儿坐在椅子上，同时由研究人员帮婴儿戴上一顶有弹性的软帽。这顶软帽上的探头会连接到功能性近红外光光谱仪，简称 apneas， 可以收集婴儿的大脑活化状况。接着让婴儿反复学习，听到声音就会看到图片的对应关系。之后在测试阶段随机省略原本应该紧接着声音出现的图片。与此同时，我们以 FNS 收集负责处理视觉讯号的大脑枕叶神经活动。研究结果显示，因为婴儿大脑能够预测图片会紧接着声音出现，所以即便图片没有出现，枕叶也会产生神经活动。团队称此神经活动为大脑预测讯号，显示婴儿的大脑预测力。
In the first study, the neural signature prediction at 6 and 12 months of age, was associated with greater language production in these same infants at 12 and 18 months of age. In the second study, the amount of storybook reading that parents provided to their infant language in infants, but crucially, that association was enhanced by the predictive brain signal measured with FNIRS.
共读能够刺激大脑预测力，可能有以下两种原因。首先，即使在与不大说话的婴儿共读时，成人还是会与预测性的问题和婴儿互动。例如，接下来我们会看到什么动物呢？绘本提供讯息结构化的情境，让孩子的大脑能够在此情境中反复练习预测新的讯息。其次，共读也可能提供互动轮替式的情境。互动轮替时，双方必须不断地预测彼此的思想行为，并提前准备好对应方式，才能在对方停顿时做出及时的反应。而共读让婴儿有更多的机会进行互动轮替。
These two studies were published in very high quality journals, Brain and Language, and PLOS One.And we look forward to continuing our collaborative research on infant language development as part of the NTNU Haskins partnership.